Guys, Empathy Bolt here, just doing a 6.0 PvE guide to the Arcane Mage. Today I'm going to talk about glyphs, talents, and what our mastery does. Let's start with our glyphs. Number one most important glyph is our glyph of Arcane Power. This increases the duration and the cooldown of your Arcane Power by 100%. Arcane Power is our most offensive cooldown as an Arcane Mage, so it's just important that we can have this for a longer period of time. It's just really fun to see the numbers that you can get with it as well. Arcane Power is a pretty badass ability. The next one is Glyph of Arcane Explosion. This increases the radius of my Arcane Explosion by 5 yards. This is pretty important because when you cast Arcane Explosion and it does damage to a target, this refreshes the stack of your Arcane Blast. So for an instance, let's say you're at 4 stacks and you're moving on a boss and you're about to lose these 4 stacks. And if you lose these 4 stacks, you know you have to climb back up to 4 stacks. So it's really like painstaking to know the damage that you do is just minimal. So you can cast Arcane Explosion and just refresh the full duration at 4 stacks of Arcane Blast. So it's really important. It's really cool to have. If you don't want to use this one, you can always use the glyph of Cone of Cold. This increases the damage done by your Cone of Cold by 200%. It's good if like a bunch of mobs are in the same spot and you just can cast a quick Cone of Cold and it does a mass amount of damage. It's pretty cool to do. The next one, this is just fight based. I use on some fights Glyph of Remove Curse. This increases the damage you deal by 5% for 10 seconds after you remove a curse from a friendly player. So it's just cool to have. It's cool to line up with certain things, maybe a second potion or something like that, just to see some bigger numbers. If you don't use Glyph of Remove Curse, I would recommend Rapid Displacement. And what this glyph does is this gives you 2 charges of blink instead of 1, but it also does remove the fact that you can blink out of stuns and bonds. So for an example, we're on Malkorok Mythic and you get Rapid Displacement and you're stuck in place, you can't blink out of it, whereas normally you'd be able to blink out of it. But with this glyph, you can blink twice. It's really good for situations, it's really good for raid awareness, it's really good for just a lot of things that have 2 blinks. I mean, 30, that's just a huge amount of space you can cover in no time at all. It's just really fun to play around with. All the minor glyphs are just fun things. I use the Glyph of Illusion because, I don't know, I kind of get sick of looking at undead for hours and hours. So I just hit this cool little button and I turn into something crazy looking for a few minutes. It's just nice for a good change of pace. I also like to summon a little vile familiar that just kind of follows me around. You know, someone to talk to or something like that if you feel me. And then rapid teleportation. I run 70% faster for 1 minute after I teleport. It's just kind of cool to have. Let's check out our talents. So these are kind of fun things to play around with. Our level 15 talent, Ice Flows. You get 3 charges of Ice Flows. And what this does is when you cast these charges, you can cast Arcane Blast or Arcane Missiles while you're moving. That's so cool. I'm trying to build stacks on the beginning of a boss fight and I can't reach the boss right away. I have to wait until he's pulled to a certain point. I can go up and I can pre-cast my Arcane Blast, get 3 stacks of Ice Flows on me and just run with the boss. It's pretty cool. It then like sets up your 4 stacks right when you stack up so you can start your big damage like cooldowns. It's pretty cool. It's really fun to play with. Our level 30 talent has to be Ice Barrier. What Ice Barrier does is every 25 seconds you can cast it on yourself and it absorbs 10,000 damage. It's really good for the minor CD on raid bosses. It's really fun. The level 45 talent, I choose Ring of Frost. There's a lot of mobs and stuff like that in instances and dungeons and whatnot that are frozen by Ring of Frost. You put this Ring of Frost down, they enter it, and then they get frozen for 10 seconds. That's pretty cool. You can then like focus where mobs are. You can hard switch to them on AoE. It's a really fun raid tool to have, and it saved the raid a lot of hassle. It's a pretty cool tool to have. In our level 60 talent tree, there's 2 things that you can ultimately choose from. For farm content, I like greater invisibility. You instantly cast invisibility, so you're instantly invisible. And then while you're invisible, you take 90% less damage. And then even 3 seconds after you come out of invisibility, you take 90% less damage. So it's pretty cool. You can soak certain things, you can become a pretty good raid utility with that. And then the next one has to be Cauterize. Whenever you die, you are instantly revived back with 35% health, and then that health dwindles by 28% over 6 seconds. And then this can only happen once every 2 minutes, so every 2 minutes you pretty much have 135% HP. It's kind of a cool thing to have for progression, seeing bosses, seeing content. It's really fun to play with as well. You can just ice block to cauterize and be at 35% HP. It's really fun. This is where it gets a little tricky, the level 75 tier. Nether Tempest is good if you have targets that are consistently in one area. Nether Tempest now scales with Arcane Blast, so you have to Nether Tempest at 4 Arcane Blast stacks. Kind of just another thing to pay attention to. Right now I like to use Supernova, and what Supernova does is it causes a pulse of Arcane Energy around the enemy, dealing 6,000 damage, and it knocks the enemy up in the air. You get 2 charges of this, and it's on a 25 second recharge, so it comes back relatively quickly. You can also get Arcane Missile procs out of this, so that's pretty important if you can weave it in to your like DPS PvE rotation. It's very important that you do so. Just the amount of damage that you can do with this Supernova, I've seen some pretty crazy numbers, and I've done some pretty cool stuff on trash with Supernova. It's just a really fun tool to play with. It's crazy shit. It's fun as hell. For the level 90 talent, I've seen Mirror Images has taken just a far toll above anything else. What Mirror Images does is it's on a 2-minute cooldown, it summons 3 copies of me. And what these 3 copies do, they just kind of look at the target and they just kind of go ape shit. And they just blow it up. This is my number one most damaging ability on any boss that I'm moving on. If you're on a patchworky fight, Rune of Power is definitely the better option. This increases your damage done by 15% while you're in the Rune of Power. It's pretty cool, but I've seen a lot of times where I'm accidentally out of the Rune of Power and I'm casting, so I'm not really getting 100% uptime. So it's really not good for mobility fights. It's really good for anchor fights. Just the amount of damage you can do in a Rune of Power, you can see it scale so much better when you're actually not moving and you can just spam your abilities, which is ultimately what us Arcane Mages are pretty good at, right? And that's pretty much it. The next thing I want to talk about is our mastery, and this kind of goes back. Our mastery increases our damage done by the amount of mana we have unused. So if we're at 100% mana, and I have 86% mastery, which is my example, that's what I have. I have 86% mastery, so I do 86% increased damage at 100% mana. So if I delve down to 90% mana, I delve down a little bit in the percentage of damage that is increased. So it's kind of important that we stay at about 80% or above in mana, even for our burn phases and stuff like that. You kind of don't want to dip down. I've noticed that once you dip down, it's kind of really hard to get out of the hole. You lose a lot of DPS trying to get back to 100% mana, so that way you have all of your cooldowns ready and you can just unload again when the time comes. That's my guide for right now. That's pretty much all I got. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll be sure to keep in touch with you guys, and I'll see you guys in WoD. Take it easy, folks.